Differential Geometry 2. Lecture 2. Copyright Alexander and Michael Bronstein. Tosca.cs.technion.ac.il/book. Numerical Geometry of Non-Rigid Shapes. Stanford University, Winter 2009. 1. Intrinsic and Extrinsic Geometry. First fundamental form describes completely the intrinsic geometry. Second fundamental form describes completely the extrinsic geometry, the layout of the shape in ambient space. First fundamental form is invariant to isometry. Second fundamental form is invariant to rigid motion, congruence. If n are congruent, i.e., then they have identical intrinsic and extrinsic geometries. Fundamental theorem, a map preserving the first and the second fundamental forms is a congruence. Said differently, an isometry preserving second fundamental form is a restriction of Euclidean isometry. An intrinsic view. Our definition of intrinsic geometry, first fundamental form, relied so far on ambient space. Can we think of our surface as of an abstract manifold immersed nowhere? What ingredients do we really need? Smooth two-dimensional manifold. Tangent space at each point. Inner product. These ingredients do not require any ambient space. Riemannian geometry, Riemannian metric, bilinear symmetric. Positive definite smooth map. Abstract inner product on tangent space of an abstract manifold. Coordinate free. In parametrization coordinates is expressed as first fundamental form. A farewell to extrinsic geometry. Bernard Riemann. 1826-1866. An intrinsic view. We have two alternatives to define the intrinsic metric using the path length. Extrinsic definition. Intrinsic definition. The second definition appears more general. Nash's embedding theorem. Embedding theorem, Nash, 1956, any Riemannian metric can be realized as an embedded surface in Euclidean space of sufficiently high yet finite dimension. Technical conditions. Manifold is four-dimensional manifold. Embedding space dimension is practically intrinsic and extrinsic views are equivalent. John Forbes Nash. Born 1928. Uniqueness of the embedding. Nash's theorem guarantees existence of embedding. It does not guarantee uniqueness. Embedding is clearly defined up to a congruence. Are there cases of non-trivial non-uniqueness? Formally. Given an abstract Riemannian manifold, and an embedding. Does there exist another embedding? Such that and are incongruent? Said differently. Do isometric yet incongruent shapes exist? Bending shapes admitting incongruent isometries are called bendable. Plane is the simplest example of a bendable surface. Bending, an isometric deformation transforming into bending and rigidity. Existence of two incongruent isometries does not guarantee that can be physically folded into without the need to cut or glue. If there exists a family of bendings continuous WRT such that and the shapes are called continuously bendable or applicable. Shapes that do not have incongruent isometries are rigid. Extrinsic geometry of a rigid shape is fully determined by the intrinsic one. Alice's Wonders in the Flatland. Subsets of the plane. Second fundamental form vanishes. Everywhere. Isometric shapes and have identical first and second fundamental forms. Fundamental theorem, and are congruent. Flatland is rigid. 10. Do non-rigid shapes really exist? Rigidity conjecture. If the faces of a polyhedron were made of metal plates and the polyhedron edges were replaced by hinges, the polyhedron would be rigid. In practical applications, shapes are represented as polyhedra, triangular meshes, so. Leonhard Euler. 1707-1783. Do non-rigid shapes really exist? 11. Rigidity conjecture timeline. Euler's rigidity conjecture, every polyhedron is rigid. 1766. Cauchy, every convex polyhedron is rigid. 1813. 1927. Cohn-Vossen, all surfaces with positive Gaussian curvature are rigid. Gluck, almost all simply connected surfaces are rigid. 1974. Connolly finally disproves Euler's conjecture. 1977. 12. Connolly sphere isocohedron rigid polyhedron Connolly sphere. Non-rigid polyhedron. Connolly, 1978. 13. Almost rigidity. Most of the shapes, especially polyhedra, are rigid. This may give the impression that the world is more rigid than non-rigid. This is probably true, if isometry is considered in the strict sense. Many objects have some elasticity and therefore can bend almost isometrically. No known results about almost rigidity of shapes. Gaussian curvature, a second look. Gaussian curvature measures how a shape is different from a plane. We have seen two definitions so far. Product of principal curvatures. Determinant of shape operator. Both definitions are extrinsic. Here is another one. For a sufficiently small perimeter of a metric ball of radius is given by Gaussian curvature, a second look. Riemannian metric is locally Euclidean up to second order. Third order error is controlled by Gaussian curvature. Gaussian curvature measures the defect of the perimeter, i.e., how is different from the Euclidean. Positively curved surface, perimeter smaller than Euclidean. Negatively curved surface, perimeter larger than Euclidean. Theorema egregium. Our new definition of Gaussian curvature is intrinsic. Gauss remarkable theorem. In modern words, Gaussian curvature is invariant to isometry. Formula attack sponte producet ad egregiam theorema, see superficies curva in quam conculium superficium explicatur, mensura curvaturi in singulis punctis invariatum in a. Carl Friedrich Gauss. 1777-1855. An Italian connection. Intrinsic invariance. Gaussian curvature is a local invariant. Isometry invariant descriptor of shapes. Problems. Second order quantity, sensitive to noise. Local quantity, requires correspondence between shapes. Gauss-Bonnet formula solution, integrate Gaussian curvature over the whole shape. Is Euler characteristic. Related genus by stronger topological rather than geometric invariance. Result known as Gauss-Bonnet formula. Pierre Roche and Bonnet. 1819-1892.